Hello, I welcome all to this channel for another interesting video. In today's video, we will discuss how merchant ships produces fresh water from seawater at sea. Contents of this video. Number 1, we will discuss about the properties of seawater and its limitations. Number 2, uses of fresh water on board. Number 3, principle behind production of fresh water at sea, types of freshwater generators. Number 4, components of freshwater generators. And number 5, limitations of producing fresh water at sea. Now let's start from the very beginning. What is seawater? Seawater is a complex mixture of 96.5% water, 2.5% of salts, and other small substances. Now, why can't we consume seawater? Seawater contains salt. When humans drink seawater, their cells are thus taking in water and salts. The salt content in seawater is much higher, which humans can't ingest. Now, let's discuss about the uses of fresh water on board a ship. Fresh water is used on board for drinking, cooking, laundry purposes, cooling medium for engines and other machineries, boilers, and in tank cleaning, etc. On an average, crew member consumes around 100 liter of fresh water per day. There are two basic processes involved in producing fresh water. Number 1 is reverse osmosis. Number 2 is distillation. On cargo ships, we use distillation for freshwater productions. Now, what is distillation? Distillation is a process of separating fresh water from seawater by boiling seawater in evaporator, and evaporated vapors later gets condensed in a condenser. In distillation types, there are two types of freshwater generators. Number 1 is plate type. Number 2 is tube type. Basic principle involved in all low pressure freshwater generators. The basic principle is that the boiling point of water can be reduced by reducing the pressure of atmosphere surrounding it. For producing fresh water at sea, we need number 1, seawater. Number 2, heat source. Number 3, source of vacuum. Now, seawater is easily available out at sea. The source of heat for fresh water generator could be waste heat rejected by main engine jacket cooling water. Now, what about the vacuum? The combined air brine ejector creates vacuum in the evaporator shell by driving seawater continuously. Hence, using energy from the heating coil and by reducing pressure inside the evaporator shell, boiling can take place at around 40 to 60 degrees Celsius. Later, the desalted vapors passes through the demister, will come in contact with the condenser where it will be condensed by means of incoming cold seawater. The distilled water is then taken out by distillate pump and controlled by selenometer and solenoid valve and later transferred to freshwater tanks. Now let's discuss about the components of freshwater generator. Number 1 is evaporator shell. It is a shell where seawater is evaporated with the help of waste heat rejected by the main engine jacket cooling water. Seawater is evaporated at lower temperature because of vacuum inside the shell. Number 2 is condenser shell. Evaporated vapors get condensed here with the help of incoming cold seawater. Number 3 is distillate pump. Distillate pump is used to transfer produced fresh water to freshwater tanks. Number 4 is ejector pump. Ejector driven by ejector pump creates vacuum inside the shell. Number 5 is demister. A demister is a thickened layer of mesh structure fitted in between the condenser and the evaporator element. It is used to separate seawater from the steam vapors. Number 6 is selenometer. A selenometer is a device installed on freshwater generator capable of detecting even the slightest of salt content in sampling water. It is connected to the distillate output just before the solenoid operated three-way valve. The selenometer output is fed to the control panel, which then based on required salt limit will send fresh water for storage or back to the freshwater generator. Solenoid valve. Solenoid valve opens up to the high return salinity distillate back to the evaporator.
And finally, number 8 is flow meter. Flow meter tells us about the actual freshwater production in a day or in an hour. Now let's discuss about limitations of producing freshwater at sea. Freshwater generator can be used at sea when the engine is running at more than maneuvering RPM. We cannot use freshwater generator for producing freshwater at ports or near to the land because of the poor quality of seawater. It may contain mud or other substances which can be harmful for the freshwater generation system. So I tried to cover all the basic concepts behind freshwater production at sea. Please do share this video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you.